oops, hold on, let's get this angle right. Sorry, making you all feel sick. Nicky here, Smurfy161. So I'm here to play with Cindy Utter's May Pick 10. She does, I mean, if you haven't heard of her, then I'm quite surprised because I think most people know her in the YouTube world of things. Each month she does her own like play session with a pick 10, and I really liked it, so I like to sort of join in. So for my base I'm just using some old packaging, and then I've got her pick 10. Some of the things I've had to change a bit to stuff I've got, which is really nice when you actually hear Cindy say, just because that's the 10 things she's picked, if you haven't got it, then adapt it. Because like the first one was, what was it, something like water acrylic, something like that. So I'm just going to water down some paint. Yeah, and just thought I'd come on and do it on camera sort of thing. So I've got some paint here. So I've gone for quite bright colours this time. I wanted to go bright and fun. So I said, oh crumbs, that's way too much, never mind. So I'm just going to splatter them, water them down and let it drip and stuff. And I've definitely used too much paint there, so let me just find a paintbrush just to spread that out a bit, because I've just gone a bit mad, obviously. Never mind, gonna have a big bit of orange. Won't need any more orange on this. Oh dear, never mind. So just gonna let that dribble and go. I'm not gonna worry obviously about getting on the back of the car, because it's just mixed fun, but I think I'm just gonna get some kitchen roll and sort that problem out. Oopsie, never mind. I don't care. Right, let's try not to use too much blue this time. Maybe I should have watered it down a bit more before I put it on there, but like I said, I'm just playing. I don't know how things are gonna go or anything. Oops. That's not gonna splotch more. Sorry, I know you can't see this on camera too well, so maybe if I turn it that way. The back of the card's getting just as messy. Let's just get my kitchen roll and clean that a bit. Just so I don't get too mucky then. Right. Let's just do something like that. And spritz some water on that and see what happens. Yeah, this is just some old packaging I had from some cards. So I think what I'm going to do with this yellow is I'm going to probably flick it, I think. I don't know yet, haven't decided. This is quite runny paint anyway, so let's just put a splodge there and see what happens. Probably isn't the best card to do it on, because it's quite dark card, but I'm not gonna worry. I want some more yellow. Oops, so let's just put the blob there and go that way. Oops. Ooh, I'm making a big fat mess. Ooh, lovely, lovely. Glad I put my art shirt on. Right, let's just get that and dry up some of that. So I'm just going to dry that with the heat gun. So I will see you in a bit. So I'm always having trouble getting the angle. So I've just dried that off a bit. So step two is random words in three areas. So I'm just going to get my words. I will just apologise now if I have to keep getting bits and stuff, because I haven't got enough room on my desk to have everything out and stuff, so I'm having to go back and forth, so I might have to like join some bits together. So I'm just going to find some. So I've just got my word box. I'm just going to have a rummage. Like I said, I'm not looking at all. I know you can't see that, so that's one word. It's got fantastic, delight, and then we want one more, and timeless. So I won't get up at the moment, so I'm going to glue them down. Let's just get rid of that. Just realised I've got paint on my hand and I've just scratched my head, so that could be fun to see. So I'm not sure. I think I might use a Pritt stick to glue these down. I'm just going to get something to pop that on. Yeah, so this, I really enjoyed them. This is like May, so I've only been doing it this year. I think Cindy might have done it last year as well. So it says in round three, random words in three areas. So we've got fantastic there, and then let's do timeless. I probably said before, I really like this sort of thing, because you've obviously got no idea how, I mean, obviously I know what I'm doing, but when Cindy does hers, she's just picking them and got no idea. So obviously, I've got a rough idea of things that are going on there, but I don't plan it at all. I mean, I had no control over where that paint was going to go or anything like that. I find it really fun. And let's do that one at that angle, which is delight. So then we can move that. Yeah, so go and have a look at her channel if you've not watched anything and you want to play along. She's also got a Facebook page called Artsy Endeavours. So that was step two. Step three is stencil. So I'm just going to get a stencil. So just bear with me while I get that. And I've got one that came in a magazine. It's a magazine freebie and it's chevron, so I think I'm going to use that. So I'm just going to get I want some more of that blue, so I'm just going to get a sponge, and I'm just going to use some more of that turquoise because it's like my fave color. So let's just put, oops, I'm running out on that. So yeah, stencil. So that's step three. So if you want to fast forward over these bits, then please feel free to do so. This stencil, like I said, was free in a magazine, so it's a it's a little bit temperamental. It's really thin, so I don't think I would be able to do texture paste through it. I don't think it would be it would like that too much, so just have to do it like this, which is fine. It was free in a magazine, so I'm not going to worry. Let's have a bit there, so I need a bit more. Oh, actually, I've got these paints mixed together. Yeah, let's have a mix. Oh, that's a bit grungy, but never mind. Sorry, I started to do a tune. Sorry, apologise. Oh, I like that. I actually think I'm going to put some on there, so I need a bit more of my teal paint. So the paints I'm using, I've got Do Crafts paint, and I've got Lagoon, so I should have said, Indigo Blue Banana Custard Matte, and then this Chilton Arts one, just bright orange. I am very much a blue teal girly, so... Right, I'm just going to clean that off a bit, so just bear with me, because I don't really want to keep pausing the camera, because then it's a pain for me to, well, it's not a pain, I don't mind, but I got to keep joining it together, and it just takes more time, and I'm not really in the mood for that. That can go there. I know Cindy Atta never cleans hers off. I clean mine off a little bit, so I'm just going, oh, let's just leave it up there. Right, don't need that at the moment. So, neon colour crayon, neon colours. I haven't actually got them, but I've got the Tim Holtz crayon, so I will do that instead, because I haven't got that. So, like I said, it's quite fun to, you know, play along with this. If you haven't got those supplies, then I'm adapting with the Tim Holtz crayons. So that's a bit purple. I'll just use my finger for this. I was going to use baby wipes, but I'm not going to worry too much. Oops. Maybe I should have dried the paint off. So hold on. Just bear with me, because I'm just going to dry where I put that stenciled paint. So I'll see you in a little bit, because this is going to take a bit of drying. Okay, hopefully the angle's still okay. Yep, I'm not too bad in frame. I know you're missing this bit here, but it's not too drastic. So yeah, I'm still on the crayons. Sorry, I should have said what colour I use. So the Tim Holtz crayons. So I've got Picked Raspberry and Wilted Violet and Salty Ocean. So I'm just going to use these around the... round my words, so I don't feel like I want to do too much with these. Maybe I should have picked a different colour to go around there. And then I'm just blending them with my fingers, and my art shirt is getting really quite colourful now. So let's just blend that like that, just to make them pop a bit. I'll just give these a blast just to dry that bit. I'm sure my paint gun, like everybody else, is covered in paint. I've just got orange paint all over the table. Never mind. Just things to get it on. Right, so that was... Right, and then... So that was step four, neon colour, and I went for the Tim Holtz crayons. Empty packaging, so some packaging. I did know this one, so I've got this corrugated card. It had some paintbrushes that I ordered off eBay in it. So I think I'm just going to stick, maybe, I don't want to cover up too much, so I think I'm just going to rip this down a bit and have that there, I think. And I might have that bit there. Yep, so let's just tear that bit off. So I'm just going to get some of my slap it on, because I know that's the best stuff to put it on with. No, that's not that. Ha ha, slap it on. If I can get into the thing. Oh my God. So let's just get a palette knife. Maybe that's a bit much. Let's stick these down. So yeah, empty packaging. So I'm just gonna, and then at least I know it's stuck really firm. So the, just in case you're a bit new to stuff like me, it's the Indigo Blue Super Thick Slap It On, and it says use great for stenciling, creating texture, and you can try adding paint, pigments, glitter or micro beads for a fabulous effect. But I know it can also, I've also used it for gluing stuff, and I find it fine. It might not be the best stuff, but that's what I'm using. It's what I've got. So, so that was going to go there. Right, let's just give that a clean. Where's the baby wipe? Baby wipe. Oh, right. Found it. don't know why I'm telling you, because none of you can tell me, get it? You can, might even be able to see it. But, oh dear, I'm in a funny mood again. Oops. I will find that in a minute. That can go in there. Where's the lid? There's the lid. So I'm just going to pop that back because I'm running out of space on the desk as it is. Right. So that's that done. And then number 6 is handmade stamps or your own stamps. I do have one handmade one. So, oh, where's it gone? I can't find it. Aha. So I've got this little one, which is actually a rubber that I've turned upside down because it's actually run out. So let me just find my black ink pad. So I've got Memento Tuxedo Black. So I keep meaning to try and make some more of my own. So I'm just going to add these little circles here and there. I got that one. Do a few there. But I mean, if you haven't got a handmade stamp, then use a different stamp, which is actually what I'm going to get in a minute. So I'm just going to get my, whoops, put that back where that comes, and I'm just going to find a stamp. So just bear with me. So I'm going to use one of my background ones. What should I use? Decisions. Decisions, decisions. Ooh, crumbs are flying off me now. Right. I think I'll use that one. So I've just got a gorgeous girl stamp that's just got those on. I'm not going to use the whole bit of it, I'm just going to use parts of it. I think that's still a bit wet there, so. And some there, and a bit there. Right, so I think that's enough stamping for me. So let's just pop that up there. Right, let's pop that away. Pop that back in there. I don't think it would matter what size my desk is, I still wouldn't have enough room. Right, so you're still saying, right. So, yeah, we've got stamp. Now, finger painting, so that's going to be quite fun, and I'm definitely going to do it on there. So I'm going to have some of this yellow. Oh, and I just thought, now I'm going to keep to these colours. So, that's just, see, this paint's really nice, but it's ever so runny, so maybe if I just put a little bit in the lid. Oops. Just a bit. I do. Right, so I've just put some of the paint in the lid. So, because then I won't contaminate. So I'm just going to brush it along this corrugated card just to give that some colour. This is fun. I know some people would hate putting their finger in paint. Actually, now I've got too much of that, so let's just do some along the edge. Give it a bit of a border here and there. I remember not to lick my finger because it's not like such a thing that I do. You sort of automatically then lick your finger afterwards, and I'm like thinking, really don't want to do that with paint. Let's put a bit there. Right, so that's yellow. I haven't got much orange, so I think I'm going to bring some more orange in. Let's just clean my finger up a bit. So I have a little bit of orange somewhere too. I'm really liking this. Like I said, you have absolutely no idea of where these pages are going to go. I love it. I think it's so much fun. It's almost like an excuse to go, yes, just play. Have some play. Let's just add some little bits there. Splodge there. Have a bit more there. I'll add a bit there, a bit there, a bit there. Some of that. So that top bit's gone really orangey now, but never mind. Right. Yeah, I'm liking that. Oh, I like it over the yellow, it's sort of, yes, like that. Right, so that's that bit. So that's just I'm not totally grungy, but. Right, so that was finger paint. Then add plaster tape. I haven't got plaster tape, so I am just going to go and grab some. In fact, I'm going to give this a dry, and then I will grab some washi. So I will see you in a little. Let me just get you in at the right sort of angle. So yeah, so we've done. Let me just refresh myself, and more than anything. So one was watered down paint. Two was random words in three areas. Three was stencil. Four was neon colour, but I went with Tim Holtz crayons. Empty packaging, which was these bits. Handmade stamp, which was those little circles, and then I used another stamp. Finger painting. Oh yeah, number eight is plaster tape, but I haven't got plaster tape, so I've got some washi, and it's got like a graffiti pattern on it. So I'm just going to put this in some places. I think the paint's still a little bit, it's still a bit wet, but I can adapt. So I'm not sure, I think I might. And what, this orange is bugging me a bit, so I think I'm just going to put some, I don't mind, I'm not a big fan of orange, so I think I just want to sort tone that down with this washi, which I got off eBay. So I've got a little section there, let's put something, let's put that like that. Because this washi is a little bit see-through, but not drastically. And then we'll do something like that. But I always like to do things in sort of three, so I might, I don't know. I like that. I think I'll just leave that washy as it is. I might, oh yes, just extend that as I rip that bit off. So right, that's the plus now splatter, and of course I've put the paint away, but I will just go and get another paint out. Oh. Sorry, you're hearing me clang and go. So I've bought myself, a little while back, I bought some white and black paint. So I think I'm just going to use this white paint, but I need to put it on something because this is all grungy. So I'm just going to get something to put the paint on. Found my paper plate. Because obviously I want to water this down. So yes, splatter. Oh God. Well, that was certainly, just making sure I haven't got that on the carpet. Sorry, the paint has just exploded on me. So, just bear with me a second and I will just sort out this problem. I would pause the camera again, but I've just done it quite a bit already. So, thankfully most of that went on the glass cutting mat. Really don't fancy getting paint on the carpet again. Oh no, it went on the lens of my camera. Not on the camera, the camera lens. Oh, sorry, I'm just, I want to clean this up while I'm, you know, I certainly don't want it on the camera lens. So, sorry, just bear with me a minute while I just sort this out. Might take me too much longer. Sorry about that. Oh, I have to remember that that white paint is, certainly primed. Right, so I'm just going to water down this paint and find a brush to splatter with. I haven't actually got a proper splatter brush, so I'll just have to I need some more water. I've either got too much or not enough. And I thought the white would be, I didn't want to go too dark. I want to keep this nice and fun and bright. And hopefully you can let's put some more on that. Okay, let's just get a bit more. Oh, this is so much fun. I'm loving it. Right, okay, so that's that dealt with. So, oh, it's got stuck to there. So let's just pop that down there. And give that a blast with the gun again. Okay, so we've done splatter, and the last one is geometric shapes. Well, I cut out some shapes, and I am going to, I think I might put that over the word delight, and as I've already got some circles, I will add some more shapes, I think. Oops, everything's just running out on me today, so it's lucky. I'm so grateful I've put my old art shirt on. Sorry, I said that a minute ago, didn't I, but don't know if it's because it's got a bit warm. Let's just spread that out a bit. Oh. Lovely, lovely, lovely mess. Mess, mess, mess. Thankfully, this dry glue dries clear. Not this dries glue. I can't get my words out right. Sorry, I'm just sorting myself out a bit again. I really have made the biggest, loveliest mess out. It's just everywhere. Don't mind it. Oh, that's just blobbed on the table. Right, try not to clear. Sorry, I'm giving myself a telling off. Don't clean stuff up on camera, sort it out in a minute. I'm still cleaning it as I'm saying don't do it. Right, okay, so geometric shape. I've already got some circles. I don't think I'm going to add the geometric shapes because I've already got the circles there and I've got that circle. So I am going to call this done. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you all will take part in Cindy's challenge and the rest of your week goes all right. Take care. Bye. Oh, hold on. Before I actually go, let me just turn it round and then you can see it a bit better. So hold on. Let me just come out a bit because obviously I've got to wait for this to dry. And so hopefully you can see it. If I lift it up a bit, if I can. That's stuck to the paper. So that is my take on Maze challenge. So I am definitely going. See you all soon. Bye.